Hi YouTubers, hi co-creators, Chief Making guys, making sure I'm straight. Hope you guys are all doing good. It's not so much a day sort of update, but a challenge update. I just started from a couple days ago. I hit my day 40, so it's a new stage, almost halfway there. And I'm finding that there are certain days I'm more motivated than other days. And I figured out why. I'm focusing on manifestations, but not focusing on daily goals and finding daily intentions, which I find Lilu does. And it's so, I just find she's so focused and she lives with such intent every single day. And it's very inspirational. So I have decided to incorporate that into my days, whether it's having a successful day, intending to finish my task list, things like this. I just find giving myself smaller goals every day will lead me to my bigger manifestations every day. We can't manifest material things all day every day. Wouldn't it be nice if it just started showering on us? But it doesn't, and we've got to keep ourselves going in the meantime. So that's what I'm doing. What else? Oh, I'm remembering it. To help me keep my focus up, I'm not only remembering the manifestations I've just recently had that were a bit more material, but every day I come to a job that I fully believe I manifested. The company I'm working at right now, first of all, the city I'm in right now was the city I intended to come to work for another company who I was in touch with. But there was a delay in the process of me getting hired. And this company that I'm working for right now, which I'd never heard of, contacted me in the process. The other company didn't end up working out, and I ended up coming to the same city but a completely different job. So the intention worked out, the manifestation came to life, and completely shocking. So that's that. I'm also getting such pleasure from, first of all, I'm going home next week, so I'm just making little purchases for friends and family just to spoil them, and it's just so wonderful to be able to spread that. I've gotten so much and I've been so blessed, and it's so amazing to be able to pay it forward. It's my best friend's 30th birthday on June 30th, so it's her lucky year as well. And she's just been such an amazing friend to me. I've known her since I was 13, so we've gone through adolescence and all of high school and college and university, and got amazing stories, and there's just so much to celebrate with her. She's an incredible woman, and she's now a mother and a wife and just an incredible one, and I cannot wait to celebrate her and who she is. So I'm getting her a really gorgeous purse. Can't wait to see her face when she opens it up. So that's it. So I'm keeping my flow. I'm keeping in the joyous mood, and not necessarily because manifestations are happening, just because I am hopefully spreading that to other people. And that's it. Talking about spreading joy, I was watching Megan's video and it totally brought me back. She had this about, I don't know, a video from a year ago about her art room and how she had a decorator come take a look at it. And the decorator told her to take out all the color and to make it all white. And it just brought me back to when I had just gotten engaged. I had gone to a florist with my mom to just look at centerpiece arrangements for the wedding. I have a feeling I'm still crooked. It must be annoying. Okay. And so he's apparently highly reputable, and he did my cousin's wedding, and it's like she poo poo guy. Anyway, so we went in, and he asked me what my color scheme is and the flower arrangements I would like, what ideas I have. And our wedding colors are yellow, like bright yellow, and white. Yellow is my favorite color, and thankfully my fiance is okay with the yellow theme, so that's what we're going with. And the flowers are going to be yellow roses and daisies, because yellow roses are just gorgeous, and daisies are my favorite flower. You know, the white daisy with the yellow center is just such a perfect combination. Anyway, so when I tell the guy that I want daisies, he looks at me and he's like, honey. And I'm like, what? And he's like, daisies are, what did he say? Daisies are the carnation of the 80s. That's what he said. Daisies are the carnation of the 80s. And he kind of like looked at me with this disgusting face, and I'm like, okay, so what do you suggest, you know? And so he started making all these suggestions, and he threw in a few yellow flowers here and there. And then by the end of it, you know, as he's redoing this arrangements, everything done, and voila, it was at all what I had asked for. He had a bouquet of calla lilies. Calla lilies are gorgeous, like long and elegant flowers, but it's just not what I asked for, you know? And he's like, yes, this is going to be beautiful. I see it. And I'm like, and my mom's totally agreeing. And I'm like, I can't believe it. So anyways, we left and I was completely depressed and disappointed because he was supposed to be the guy. So anyways, I knew I couldn't go with this guy because in the end he said he would work with me, but I couldn't work with somebody who just completely disregarded my ideas. Anyways, so I went to this other guy I found through some more research, and when I explained to him what I was looking for, he completely loved it. He said it's original and different and that it's going to look gorgeous and that he hadn't seen it done before, but that we were going to make it work. And that's an advice: if you ever deal with clients or vendors, don't just completely knock their idea from the beginning, because they're not going to come back. Anyways, so this guy's awesome and he's doing our centerpieces and it's going to be gorgeous. So all that to say, follow your gut instinct, people, just because, I mean, this guy, I really thought he was it. You know, we had budgeted for him and it just, I knew it wasn't right and we were up against a deadline. I knew I just had like a few more, like an open window of like 3 or 4 days before I was leaving the country. So I had to find someone, and I did I just didn't give in to the first guy who gave me advice. So that's it. Stick to your gut instincts. I have another story, but it's up to 7 minutes, and I hate doing long videos, so I'll save it for another day. So that's it. Having a great day. There's still more to come, so hang on for the ride. Bye, guys.